Hi, welcome to the statics tutorials. So in this example, we're going to look at the addition of two vectors using the triangle method, and this would be also similar to using the parallelogram method. This is with the parallelogram method, you get the two triangles, and so you just solve either the top or the bottom. With the triangle method, you only get the one triangle. So in this case, we have these two vectors. A has a magnitude of 5.77 newtons at an angle of 30 degrees to the negative x-axis. B has a magnitude of 7.07 newtons at an angle of 45 degrees to the positive x-axis. If you're a little rusty on the law of cosines and the law of sines, here's the generic triangle for law of sines and law of cosines. Remember, this is for solving triangles that are not necessarily right triangles. And we can do this by solving for any side. So in this case, solving for side C. Side C is equal to the square root of sides A squared plus B squared minus 2 times the side A times the side B times cosine of little c, which is the angle that's opposite C, or the angle that spans side big C. And then law of sines is that side A divided by the sine of its angle is equal to side B divided by the sine of its angle, which is equal to side C divided by the sine of its angle. So we can apply that with this one. We just need to rearrange our vectors a little bit. So we're going to start with one of the two vectors. So I started with vector B, the 7.07 newtons, and I drew it here. I know that it's at a 45 degree angle to the x-axis, so I went ahead and drew in the angle there. Then I'm going to add vector A, but I'm going to move it so that vector A starts right at where vector B ends, and then draw it out. And then to finish my triangle, my resultant, which is just A plus B, is equal to starting where B starts and then going to the end here where B ends. So here's my triangle. Looking at my angles, I don't know this inside angle here, so I'm just going to call it A. If this is 45 and this is parallel to my x-axis, then I know that this angle over here is also 45 just from the geometry. I know that if this line's parallel to my x-axis and my vector here makes an angle of 30 degrees to the x-axis, that angle there also has to be 30 degrees. Then I can just add these two angles up and get 75 degrees. I don't know this angle, so I'm just going to label it as B. It turns out I don't even need it for this problem. So now I can calculate R because I know these two lengths of these two sides and I know the angle between the two sides. So my A and B terms now are the 5.77 and the 7.07 here, so I get these two terms squared minus 2 times these two terms again, times the cosine of this angle here, opposite side R, which is my 75 degrees. I take a square root of that, and I get 7.88 newtons. That's the magnitude of the resultant vector. Now I can apply law of sines. So I can do my 5.77 newtons divided by sine of A is equal to the resultant, 7.88 newtons, divided by sine of 75. I need to solve for A, so I'm going to multiply this equation both sides by sine A, then I'm going to divide through by 7.88 newtons, then I'm going to multiply by sine of 75. That's going to give me sine of A is equal to 5.77 newtons divided by 7.88 newtons times sine of 75. Now I just need to take the inverse sine of that and I can get my angle back. Be careful with sine, because with the trig functions, there's always multiple angles that give you the same value. But in this case, you're looking for the angle less than 90 degrees. And so getting this 45 degrees appears to be correct based on our diagram. Now I need this angle theta though, all the way back to the x-axis. So I'm gonna take the 45 that I just calculated and add the 45 for B, because A is relative to vector B. So add those two together and I get 90 degrees. That's just a coincidence in this case. Not every problem is going to give you a resultant that's along the x-axis or y-axis. And then I can write my resultant in magnitude and direction format. So I'm going to say R with the vector symbol above it is equal to its magnitude, 7.88 newtons. I'm going to draw in my x-axis, draw in my vector, and then show that the angle that I'm giving you is the angle that's measured counterclockwise from that positive x-axis. I don't have to make it actually point in the direction of R as long as I'm showing you that it's measured counterclockwise from that. And then I can put in my angle. Then I've specified my resultant. Thanks for watching.